Do LDL lipoproteins need to be oxidized before they become harmful? Is there a way to prevent that oxidation, even if we have high cholesterol or high LDL particle number? What about this blood test, oxLDL? Is that useful? Is that informative? Today, we're covering all of these questions. Our guest is Dr. William Cromwell, board-certified clinical lipidologist and fellow of the National Lipid Association with 3 decades of experience diagnosing and managing lipoprotein and metabolic disorders. Dr. Cromwell heads the Lipoprotein and Metabolic Disorders Institute. He is founder and chief medical officer at Precision Health Reports, and he is also a professor at Wake Forest University School of Medicine. He has published extensively on lipid physiology and metabolic disease. So here's my conversation with Dr. Cromwell. Enjoy. So I was wondering about this marker, oxLDL. A lot of people ask about that as well. Is it okay to have high cholesterol, high ApoB, as long as they're not oxidized in circulation? This is a common question.
The challenge with oxidized LDL is that we're talking about a marker of a blood sample. We're not talking about oxidized particles in the artery wall. So now we're trying to, 1 degree of freedom away, associate what I'm measuring in blood with what's happening in the artery wall. That's a little bit of a leap, right? Most, but not all, most oxidation occurs in the artery wall. There is some spillover effect. It is possible for you to detect oxidized LDL in the plasma. That is possible. But the lion's share of physiologically what's happening that's nasty is in the artery wall. So that's the first thing. The second thing is there is a great deal of interplay between the total quantity of ApoB and oxidized LDL. So if oxidized LDL is associated with risk, is that association just as significant if I adjust for the number of particles? The answer is no. Depending on the study, it either is greatly attenuated or it's no longer significant. It depends. Some populations, it's just badly degraded. Other populations, it's no longer significant. The question is it actionable? Did it add something that I need to know? I have not seen data that suggests that once you have lowered ApoB, oxidized LDL as a residual marker is significantly problematic and actionable. I've seen quite a bit of data where a high oxidized ApoB keeps company with increased numbers of LDL particles, and the two are packing together in such a way that my real opportunity is fix the underlying physiology, lower the ApoB, and the oxidized LDL is not a unique target unto itself.
Mm-hmm. Is there any way that one can keep high ApoB and yet block oxidation?
Not in the artery wall. Once it's retained. Arterial wall phenomenology is different than what's happening in the blood. When Brown and Goldstein were discussing their research and their Nobel Prize, Joe Goldstein said famously that trying to understand lipoproteins with a blood test is like looking in the garbage to figure out what's happening in your house. Mm-hmm. What's circulating is not a good reflection of the intricacies of LDL lipoprotein metabolism, homeostasis, and arterial wall pathophysiology. Mm-hmm. So one must be careful of what markers we sample from the blood and how we connect the dots back to the artery wall.
So do you use oxLDL with your patients? Do you see a value?
No.
Okay.
It is not actionable, and it does not add significantly to my decision.
Mm-hmm. The oxLDL that's in the blood, is that particles that were oxidized in the blood or particles that escaped from the artery wall back into circulation?
Good question. And I don't know the answer. Okay. I don't think anybody really does.
Okay.